The Bank of Canada's independence from the federal government has been under attack in recent weeks. Conservative leadership candidate Pierre Poilievre took aim at Canada's central bank, vowing to remove Governor Tiff Macklem, who he described as the Trudeau government's ATM. But what does central bank independence mean, and how does the Bank of Canada aim to uphold it? The Bank of Canada was created in 1934 by the Bank of Canada Act, which gave the governor of the institution the power to conduct monetary policy and oversee the currency however they saw fit. This legislation would also protect the bank's operational independence to go about these responsibilities as the institution desired. It's an act that has evolved over the years, one of the more notable changes being the first ever inflation targeting agreement in 1991. This would create a contract between the central bank and the federal government to set up an inflation target. However, it would ultimately be up to the central bank to achieve this target of 2% after the economy saw whipsaw inflation in the 70s and 80s. If the bank's governor and the finance minister ever hit a severe disagreement on monetary policy, the minister would have the power to give the bank a directive after it was tabled in parliament and received approval from the cabinet and governor themselves. In her first speech as senior deputy governor of the Bank of Canada on May 3rd that went into more details on this act, Carolyn Rogers said that this measure had never been used, something she credits to the respect that federal governments hold for the central bank's independence. So, what happened? How did we get to this?
Bank of Canada governor has allowed himself to become the ATM machine of this government. And so I would replace him with a new governor who would reinstate our low inflation mandate, protect the purchasing power of our dollar, and honor the working people who earn those dollars.
The Bank of Canada has admitted that it misjudged inflation, which reached 6.7% in March from a year earlier, one of the fastest rates since the early 1980s. To fight inflation and regain trust, Tiff Macklem pledged to act more forcefully in raising interest rates. We've already seen two rate hikes that brought the overnight rate up to 1%. However, Macklem signaled that he was ready to get tougher on rising costs. Macklem suggested back in April that the bank could take the overnight rate modestly above neutral for a period of time. The bank estimates this neutral rate to stand between 2 and 3% to neither help nor hinder economic growth, potentially bringing rates up to 3.25%. While some people may have been alarmed to hear Poilievre call the Bank of Canada financially illiterate, harsh criticisms against the central bank aren't anything new. James Coyne, who served as governor from 1955 to 1961, resigned from his post when he and former Prime Minister John Diefenbaker couldn't see eye to eye. The fallout of the situation would have the Bank of Canada Act rewritten as Coyne's successor, Louis Rasminsky, insisted on clear guidelines that would leave the central bank alone to its own devices on a day-to-day basis. More recently, Liberal politician Jean Chrétien clashed with Governor John Crow during the 1993 election, criticizing his strict zero inflation stance as he cranked up interest rates. Despite the disagreement, Chrétien would have left Crow in place if they could come to a compromise on monetary policy, according to Paul Martin, Chrétien's first finance minister. They couldn't, so Martin let Crow serve out his tenure and then replaced him with Gordon Thiessen. So is firing the Bank of Canada governor something Poilievre can actually pull off? Well, first he would have to win the Conservative leadership vote in September, and then the federal election to become Prime Minister in the autumn of 2025. Macklem's current 7-year term would come to an end in June 2027. This would come after the Bank of Canada's forecast predicting inflation to move closer to target at 2.4% by the end of 2024. If this prediction holds, it could be that the Bank of Canada brings inflation back to balance before Poilievre gets to remove Macklem.